Exciting changes are coming to the TTC subway system that will modernize and improve service, including an entirely new signal system. But in order to make these changes, the TTC will need to close portions of the subway system on many weekends throughout the year. Signal systems monitor the position of subway trains, allowing for their coordinated movement and informing staff in the TTC's Transit Control Center of each train's location. Today, the TTC uses the original signaling system, which remains safe but dates back in parts to when the subway first opened in 1954. The current system is called a fixed block system. Signals are located along the tracks in predetermined sections called blocks, and only one train at a time can enter each block. The blocks on either side of the train are considered protection zones. Trains must wait for the blocks to clear, leaving large gaps called headway. The fixed block system limits the number of trains that can be operated on one line at the same time. It has become increasingly unreliable, leading to delays. It also doesn't allow for the increase in train capacity that the TTC so desperately needs. The TTC has begun installing automatic train control, or ATC, to replace the old system. ATC creates a moving block for each train, a safe area that moves with the train and adjusts to the train speed. Computers make multiple calculations a second to determine how large each train's moving block should be and how close trains can safely be to one another, moving more people faster. Trains will be able to operate as frequently as every 1 minute and 55 seconds instead of the current limit of 2.5 minutes. With ATC, subway service will be more efficient and reliable, with less crowding and fewer delays. The move to ATC is essential if the TTC is to keep up with growing ridership demand. When installation is complete on the entire line in 2019, it will allow for as much as 25% more capacity. Good news for the increasing number of riders the TTC sees each year. ATC will come online on all of Line 1 in phases by the end of 2019, starting with the portion of Line 1 between Spadina and Wilson stations, and with the Line 1 subway extension into York Region that opens at the end of this year. In order to introduce ATC to the subway extension, as well as between Spadina and Wilson stations, it needs to be tested extensively. Testing is done in phases and needs time to address any issues or challenges that arise. It will be necessary to close the section of Line 1 between Downsview and St. George stations on numerous weekends throughout 2017 to complete installation, training, and testing. Weekends are chosen because there simply isn't enough time during routine nighttime maintenance to complete the work. More work is completed in one weekend closure than 5 weeks of routine nighttime maintenance. For 2017 subway closures, the TTC is changing the way it moves people. In addition to running shuttle buses through a section of the closure area, it is introducing enhanced closure service that will speed up travel times. During the closures, the TTC will add extra service on all east-west routes that run between the Spadina side of Line 1 to the Yonge side. Customers can use these routes to get to the nearest subway station on the Yonge portion of Line 1, making their trip to and from the downtown much faster. For example, if a customer needs to get from Downsview Station to the Eaton Center, they can take one of the more frequent 84 Shepherd buses from Downsview to Shepherd Station, and then travel south to Dundas Station. Train service will also be increased between Finch and Bloor-Yonge stations to accommodate the additional ridership. For those customers who are only traveling north-south within the closure area, shuttle buses will run between Downsview and Lawrence West stations. Anyone traveling within the closure area south of Lawrence West Station will have several bus routes available to them with extra service. To plan your trip using alternate routes, please visit ttc.ca. The TTC recognizes closures are inconvenient, However, once ATC installation is complete, a much improved subway service will be the result. During subway closures, the TTC will have customer service staff at all affected stations to help customers with information and ensure they make their connections seamlessly. Closure schedules and shuttle bus routings are published well in advance at ttc.ca. Or follow us on Twitter for up-to-the-minute service information.